The late 30s was a memorable era. Hitler's forces were in full effect, and Canada was at war. Cinematic history was made with Gone with the Wind and The Wizard of Oz. And the Great Depression was nearing its conclusion. But for a young family in Ontario, it would be remembered as the time when their family was broken apart, and their beloved Albert was admitted to an institution.
I just remember my mother crying a great deal. And Dad was a very quiet man, and I imagine held most of his pain in. I know one time he did tell me, and this was in just years before he died, he said, you know, when I knew that nothing could be done for Albert, he said, I felt for a while as if my life was over.
At age 3, Albert contracted whooping cough and suffered a brain injury. So at 5 years of age, at the urging of their doctor, Albert's family admitted him to the institution in Orillia. For 70 years, Albert lived there. We'll never know all that he experienced, and for most of us, we can never imagine what he lived through. The rhythm, routines, and lifestyle of institutional life, even in 2007, was alarming.
I expected the institute living to be a lot different. I thought that it was going to be changed. And when I got there, I realized that it wasn't. It was so, you know, scheduled and robotic-like. Breakfast time, I think, was the start of the day, and they would have their breakfast, and they ate within about a half an hour time. And the support staff there then said shower time, and everybody got up. They went to their rooms, they got the stuff that they needed to shower, and they all proceeded to the shower room. So it was like one sentence that was said, and everybody knew what to do. Like, there wasn't any other conversation, there was no talking, you know, like, how's your day, how's your morning, how was breakfast? It was just up, go, let's get going. And then it went from there to coffee time or into a workroom where they were doing painting or something. And it was just schedule, schedule, schedule. They took showers together in, like, in the same room and a big bathing area. So there was lines, like walls of showers that were open, like no curtains or anything. And I believe two bathtubs. So, and it was men and women at the same time that would shower together.
If there was one positive that came out of Albert's time at Huronia, it was a lifelong friendship with his buddy, Bert.
As far as I know, they were friends before they moved in as roommates. Once they became roommates, and they were roommates for 35 years, I think they had a very good, strong bond. At one point, apparently, staff up there tried to separate them and put them on different parts because I guess they didn't want them to be sort of codependent on one another. But they would walk the halls until they found each other.
In 1987, the Ministry of Community and Social Services announced that all institutions in Ontario would be closed by the year 2012. But despite the obvious shortcomings of institutional life, a number of families were concerned about the alternative arrangements and fought the move.
I was very worried. I was afraid that possibly they may put him in a nursing home. And I didn't want a nursing home environment for him. It would be hard for him to accept.
Brampton Caledon Community Living stepped up to offer Albert and his family a solution. As the process to move him from Huronia was underway, they quickly realized there'd been an oversight. Bert became aware of the plans to move Albert and made his views clearly known. If Albert was moving, he was going with him. Bert's family had many of the same concerns as Albert's, but after a little investigation, it didn't take long for them to feel comfortable with the plan.
When we heard that Bert was coming out of the institution, because, I mean, let's face it, it is a big institution, and when he was coming up to this setting in Brampton here, and we'd come up and seen the house, it was like, wow, I made a comment, you know, when can I move in, right? So, yeah, no, we're quite pleased with it.
One of the most heartbreaking things is when they came for lunch to see the house. And they came in and they were just, I'd never seen two people run like so fast, like in and out of the rooms. And Albert sat in one chair, Bert sat in one chair. They both sat on the couch, you know, everywhere, all over. And it was, but when they had to go, it was hard for them to understand. It's like, okay, we're here, why are we leaving now? Like, why are you making us leave? And that was a little bit, you know, sad.
So on December 18th, 2007, Bert and Albert moved into their new home in Brampton. The men had little trouble with the move, but after a combined 130 years in Orillia, it took some time to overcome the restrictions and rigid routines inherent to institutional life.
I expected there to be more adjustments for them, but it was simple things. It was, I guess, reassuring them that they could go into the fridge and get a drink. Like, this is where the glasses are. And this is, you know, this is where the juice is. This, and for the longest time, Bert especially would stand in front of the fridge and just stand there. And, you know, we'd have to ask him, the staff would have to say, would you like something? And then he would say, yeah, and we'd say, go in the fridge. And it was like a look of, like, what do you mean? Go in the fridge and get my own. So
the short time Bert has been here compared to the institution, like I said, I see him dress better. I know in Orillia there at the end there he was getting pretty thin, and I know a lot of that was his health, but you know, I also get the feeling because the kitchen's here and he's quite welcome to roam around his home that he's probably snacking a little bit, so he has put a few pounds on. Just the fact that he lays on the couch, you know, and he ain't getting up for nobody. Gotta tell me that he feels like he's at home. So yeah, I can see a big difference in Bert. You know, just seems to be more relaxed. Doesn't seem to be on edge.
Much more calm. He was always kind of agitated, and he's just mellowed right out. And he seems so relaxed here.